side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It's a great fake. Here's Willis. Flushed out right. He's going to let this go deep. Back over the middle. And that nearly an interception here on his opening.
Something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep. Try to throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
And a gain of four gets him right to the midfield stripe.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to be incomplete.
No surprise at all. They're looking for the big man early in this one. The only surprise for them, he couldn't hang on to the pass.
On fourth down, Ryan Stonehouse on the punt. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say crosses at the 11-yard line. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And a fumble last time. Ball security. Talk about it all the time in the National Football League. They've got to be better at it on this drive.
Don't you think that when every team gets together for the first time, I don't care if it's OTAs, mini camps, first day of camp in the regular season, ball security comes up about what, the second sentence of the coach's address?
And there's so many drills focused on that.
All the time, and they do drills to make it even tougher to see that.
Kicks away. That'll be a 43-yard punt, but a net of just 33 following a 10-yard return. And the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. Down inside the 40. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one.
And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And he is going to get this close to the first down mark as he's brought down at the Titans 33. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third and one, it's Lawrence. And that's knocked away and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
On for the field goal try, Jonathan Garibay. From the left hash, it's an even 50-yard attempt. Garibay's kick is good.
Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
Oh, yeah. Woo! Come on! Got it. Ready?
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They've shown very little offensively to this point, and neither team has really. They come up here now, first down. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five.
Stop, big stop.
Second down. Here's Willis. That's caught. Left side, it's Hurts. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
The loss, second and 12.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Willis now off play action. He's got his tight end Freiermuth right side. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 47. They'll go option to the short side. And a pretty good burst right there as he'll take this down to the 33. Call it a gain of 14 for the second play in a row.
I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react. Even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL, there's still a little bit of disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's right on the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
So give him 2 yards in on the completion. That'll be second down.
On third down.
And that is incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense is past few downs. And knock that one down, third down, and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected fourth down here.
Titans first down as they wind up with a gain of 11 there on fourth down. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Quarterbacking 101. Never force the ball into double coverage. Especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tight, you just don't want to force it in there because it could be tipped up and picked off.
after the incomplete pass. Here now is second and 10. Right back to the air again with Willis. And he's wrapped up. Taken down. Back at the 25.
Tough spot for Willis and the Titans, now facing third and long following the sack. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And oh no, it's incomplete. It's a touchdown. It's a touchdown. It's off and it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Eventually able to punch this one through, and that will tie us at 3-3.
So, Charles, they are on the board after that kick. So, three drives, 3 points, obviously not the start that you were hoping for, but they're able to erase that zero off the scoreboard.
Yeah, I guess what you're saying is a point of drive is not what offenses are striving for by any stretch. They're happy they got three now. They hope that that unlocks their offense for bigger points down the road.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. Now a throw here to his running back. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
And no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
On second down, they run here. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. Giving 15 yards on that one. Kansas City has a first down. Now, look, that wasn't a huge game, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched it more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
Right back to him on first down. And some room to maneuver. And he'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 61 yards rushing. These two teams all tied after one.
Come on now! Finish that scrimmage! Control it! Oh, come on! You're so close! Focus!
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's a handoff out of the gun. Chiefs touchdown. A great play there. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Chiefs have taken the lead. Oh, he missed the PAT. No good on the extra point, so a letdown there. And this will stay a 6-point ball game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. It's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just a 3-point CD.
If you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts. Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. And how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take
it. He's going to have to eat this one. He's going to get it.
And now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
Push through, baby. Let's do this.
Show them what you got.
Showtime. Let's make some noise.
This offense hoping to avoid the 0-2 start. They trail, but they've got a first and 10 here. Now, here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver. And it'll be brought down at about the 6-yard line. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Boy, an effective play there, getting their wideouts involved in the run game.
And what they're always hoping on that type of a play, that they can get to the end of the line and have a chance to turn it upfield as he did there. That means they controlled the blocking and took care of the defensive end of the outside linebacker to give him that lane.
And I guess I need to clarify, I said getting their wideouts involved in the run game, but of course that was actually a pass as he popped it forward. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
And Brandon, every running back wants to use their speed in order to get out in front of things. Sometimes you just have to be patient, let blocks develop. On that play, that didn't happen.
On second and goal. Yes. Touchdown.
For good reason, quarterbacks want to get the ball to the perimeter to the wide receivers for big plays. But in this situation, it felt like, based on coverage, he knew that he wanted his tight end to have the football, and for good reason.
Extra point by Badgley, up and good. And with it, his guys take the lead here by a point. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. The offense coming back out here. Plenty of energy, ready to roll, looking to just add to what they have been doing after scoring a touchdown, Charles, their last time out.
And that's a great feeling to have on the sideline, knowing you just won the battle against the opposing defense. And since they came off the field, I'll guarantee you all they want to do is get back out there, because they know they have the upper hand on that defense right now.
The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Gets it to Hardman, a jet sweep. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
Well, they gave up a few yards there, but all in all, I think it's a pretty nice job defensively against the jet sweep. If they don't slow him up, he might take it to the house, so they'll take that play every time on the defensive side of the ball.
Got an extra defensive back out there for the Titans now here for 3rd down. Lawrence. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
He came up with points in the first 2 possessions, but it looks like they'll come up empty here on their 3rd drive. The defense finally starting to get locked into them a little bit. Might have to go a little bit deeper into their playbook on their next possession.
Now on 4th down, on is the punt team sending this one away. Fielded just inside the 30. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. And that'll be a return of 12 following a very nice punt. And it'll be Titan football.
Get him!
Get in front of him!
Stop him early!
Okay, the Titans offense set to begin the drive. The last time out, they had to march almost the full length of the field for their touchdown. So here, much easier, Charles, with this better starting field position.
I love your sarcasm.
Willis takes a hit and the ball is free. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
So that play, I mean, it was pretty well blown up from the start, and it results in a turnover.
Yeah, when you're running the option like that as a quarterback, you have so many different keys and reads to make that sometimes as you're making them, you're not protecting the ball the way you should, and it gets popped free.
87 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
We knew both of these safeties were good in run support, but how about the play we just saw there? How about that closing speed? Able to get to the outside part of the field and turn that play into a loss.
On third down, Lawrence. And that will be incomplete.
Because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Garibay's kick is good. And they cannot take advantage of the short field.
Definitely a lost opportunity right there. I mean, they were in prime position to put six on the board. Ended up settling for three.
Taken in at the three. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Titans' offense set to begin the drive. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, because it didn't cost their team a touchdown, but they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Willis, a throw to the flat for Carter. And he's able to get up here to the 26. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. On third down, it's Willis. One, and that's going to be intercepted. And they'll set up shop right near midfield at the 49-yard line.
On the set.
Six, maybe. Get two mistakes out there, offense.
Get the point on the ball. Keep
the ball. Move it down the field. Down the field, offense.
On first down, they'll go to the ground and turn. And they'll work down to 7-5.
You see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Snap to Lawrence as he taps this forward. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4 yard pickup leaves him with third and one. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but bottom line, the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
The Chiefs on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. Here it's third and 2. From the gun, he'll hang his head. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Given the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play. The Chiefs had only one of the year following the loss in the opener. And listen, we knew last week they went for a tough fight on the road. But now here's the home opener and a chance to get things right.
And I like the way that you presented that, because the bottom line is they didn't come out of that loss discouraged. They just came home and said, hey, if we do what we're supposed to do, protect the home turf, we can just stop.
He's got it wide open, complete. And he's going to get this down near the 25.
Catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Throwing now, Lawrence on first down. The hitter here, it's complete. And they're going to get this down inside the 20.
Timing is so important on a route like this, because he's going to line up out right, then cut straight across the field. I think the ball might have come out a count or two too late, because by the time he was able to secure it, not much of a chance to turn it upfield. But not a fun game at all for anyone who's playing defense on the field at this point. They just gave up another first down on another good run. I wonder if the defense coordinator just says, let's sell out, play against the run, and not worry about getting beat by the pass.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as a start.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Now Lawrence. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
And based on my math, they've only converted one time thus far in this game. So you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. Third downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
Garibay's kick is good.
So far, you mentioned the early lead. Now they're expanding on it, getting plays on both sides of the ball. A winning recipe if they can keep this up.
Thank you.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. First and 10, it's Willis. And a dangerous throw there, incomplete. He threw that into coverage. That was nearly intercepted.
Another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row. With the ball, he's got to start taking care of the ball way better than we've seen.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. To throw on second and 10, Willis. That's complete to his tight end fire move. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. The Titans efficient passing on this drive. There's another first down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
Willis will look to pass again here. Here's Freiermuth again. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Hey, So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. Badgley's kick is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we have reached halftime here in a tight two-point contest. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Hey, this is what you get paid for.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. But Charles, for them, a pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ground. And traffic, and it's intercepted. And the Titans are going to take possession of the football. Not the way you envision things to start out the third quarter. One play and already a turnover.
It's interesting. You and I were talking with the coach, and he talked about how at halftime, as a play caller, he wanted to make sure he got a new script going for the second half, not just the one he operated off of to start the game. Nowhere on that script did it have that result.
On second and 15 now, Willis. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. A lot of talk this week about ball security. In fact, they added an extra period in practice to be more secure with the ball. It didn't work out there.
Well, sometimes you just get overexcited during the game. You may all of a sudden make your catch, see some open field, and decide you're going for it, and not realizing the danger lurks while you're doing so. And there's your end result right there.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. He takes this for three to the 29.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. From the gun, it's Lawrence. And he's got his man on the out route. But he won't quite make it. He needed six. He got about five. Fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. And they'll try and throw forward with Lawrence. Plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 103 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
On second and very short, Lawrence. And that is caught. Touchdown, Kansas City. 25 yards for a touchdown. And they are able to add on to their advantage. Garibay on to attempt the point after. No good. It is has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far.
Go, take the goal.
Laser focus, guys.
So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
And I'm deep.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Last time out, they had a fumble that led to the touchdown. Not a great look on either side of the ball as the defense gave up the points to Charles, but they've got to take care of the football and be better here on this possession.
It's certainly been a tough stretch, partner, for both of those units, and they kind of put their defensive mates in a really tough spot there by dropping the ball on the ground. But an easy way to make it up to them, get out there now and get some points on this drive.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Hands it off out of the gun. 7 yards there and a first down. There's a quick throw to Freiermuth. And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this.
What are you doing?
Okay, so the personal foul penalty. And those are some important yards lost right there.
Yeah, it all comes down to discipline, doesn't it? And every team tells us that they coach it, they preach it. In this case, it slipped a little bit.
And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Now they'll look to Willis to throw. They'll dump this off to Tyler complete. And they're going to be set up now with the ball at the 13-yard line.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there. Getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker, maybe a defensive end dropping out the zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
And throwing the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
There's a quick throw completed by Willis. They need to start turning some of these threes into sixes.
And for him, it's not his concern, right? He just goes out there when they call on him and goes ahead and puts points up on the board.
Go,
the
take it to the house.
Got to get together and figure out what's stalling their drives so they have to keep calling on him.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Good drive last time, really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
So now 20 yards to go on second down after the sack. Work to be done. And they'll run on the inside handle. And a nice game there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. Give him 4 yards there, but still in a big hole. Third and long.
But really, that was no surprise there. They've been running it well all game. And I know goals change all the time, but any team will take that type of run each and every time.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They wind up getting 16, but even that's not quite enough. It's fourth down.
Well, it looks like they got what they wanted. They got the completion, but they weren't able to break any tackles or gain nearly enough yardage to pick up the first down. Now to be fourth and short.
He gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick. The extra drive.
And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And that's going to bring up second down. They'll run with Carter, and he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. Here's Willis. He's got it. Big game, but a fumble. And it's picked up by the Chiefs.
It's not often that we see big plays ending disaster. And we just absolutely saw it right there. They had something really big cooking on that one.
Can you, when you're down near the goal line like that on a big play, do you get maybe a little too careless, a little too desperate for the goal line?
I think the last part is exactly right. You get desperate for the goal line, and sometimes you get the ball out of hand away from your body, or you're trying to extend to get there, or maybe you're just trying so hard that the ball will come out of your hands. In any event, that's a big opportunity lost.
114 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one.
Up through three quarters, no reason to run up now. And he'll be just shy of the 20 at the 19 as he goes up. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. A handoff as they run the counterplay. And that's going to be a Chiefs first down as he's able to take this up to the 30-yard line.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they turn to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks.
This is caught at the 20. And they're going to get this down inside the 20. They love him to stream there, so to speak. That was all set up by Ronnie Nichols.
Another example of what all the offensive coordinators tell us. When the running game's operating, it really opens up the playbook. And that's when they hit him with the play action. And you can see the defenders rushing towards the line of scrimmage, then scrambling back, trying to cover. Couldn't get there in time.
Well scripted. They had the big running play, now the big passing play. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Look at me.
And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
Set up with a first and goal from very short range.
So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
But they're certainly not neglecting their run duties as well as they ate up the blockers in front and allowed the secondary to get home.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. He'll try again. And he's going to lose yardage again as he is stuck behind the line. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down.
That's a nice example of good team defense right there. Ball was snapped at the 1 yard line. They knocked him back and caused a loss. But you notice they were trying to find any type of a gap to run through.
He'll take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Touchdown of the year, and the Chiefs go nearly the length of the field and finish it off with 6 points. Back out there now to send this one away. From a couple yards deep, we'll bring it out of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27.
And a lot of times, these plays, they even go for nothing.
They go for big yardage, and here they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
Working with a second and four. To throw, here's Willis. And this one is incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. Willis now off play action. And that falls to the ground incomplete.
Complete that pass.
Down there, boys.
That line. Yeah, 15.
Field position.
Don't let us down.
Now Lawrence on first down. A great play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Chiefs have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. Send this one away.
Big play here, offense.
Baby.
Tackle him.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You have to think that's going to be something we're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10 again from the 25-yard line.
Let's go defense!
Again to throw, Willis on second down. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
No mental mistakes out there, offense!
Go, go, on the go!
Go, go, go!
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And he'll keep leaning on the running game back to the ground. And he is going to get this close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the Titans 23. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation.
Ready, ready?
We got their defense round.
Check. Ball movement.
Do this.
One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. On for the field goal try, Jonathan Garibay. From the left hash, this from 46.
You can do it. That's an easy three.
Fellas, turn it up.
Let's get 3 points on the board.
Keep going. Keep going.
Garibay's kick is caught.
Opportunity.
Taken at the goal line.
This could be it. This could be the turning point.
Woo!
Bring it home.
Here we go.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And last time, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. See if they can pick themselves up off the mat. And he lost the football, and it's picked up by the Chiefs. And this guy's going to get the football at the 28-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you say an afternoon to forget, absolutely.
Stealing is actually legal. Yes!
We love it.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. Now the Titans will use their third and final timeout. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. On for the field goal try, Jonathan Garibay. This one from 48 yards away. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Well, CD, it's all window dressing at this point. I mean, the best they can do is end the game with a nice drive. To
loose football, and it's picked up by the Chiefs.
He's got some great throws. And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right. So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. Conversion on third and 13. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now Willis on first and 10. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off by Legarius Sneed. Facing this fourth quarter deficit, felt like they had to throw the ball on the other side. They were ready.
No doubt about it. They're playing situational football. They look at the clock. They know the lead that they have, and all they're doing is playing pass on every down.
Playing the pass, picking it off, and now big time in the driver's seat.
Let's do it.
The Patriots will come to town. Meanwhile, for the Titans, they'll drop to 0-2. And they'll try to rebound next week as they head to Glendale to take on the Cardinals.